explain what we did in our project NutriChip. So the aim of this project is to develop a microfluidic analytical platform with which we can check the quality of food. So of course you can check quality of food yourself by eating and then feeling bad or good. But we want to have kind of objective tool by which we can see if certain food types are good. And then we think in particular of dairy food, milk-derived food products. So the project is highly interdisciplinary, and it has partners from Zurich, ETH Zurich, Group Hurl, working on human nutrition. There is a group Ramsden at Basel, but also at Cranfield University, working on microsystems, cell-based systems. My group working on microfluidics and biomicromechanical systems. Group Vergère at Agroscope Liebefeld Poisieux Research Station, working on nutrition, biochemistry. They have a lot of knowledge on dairy products. Group Carrara of EPFL, working in this project on development of a sensor, both on hardware and software aspects. And the project is supported by three companies, Nestle, Microsense, and Ayanda Biosystems. And then also there is now an extra partner, if you want, in this project, which is Inselspital in Bern, where they do a human study. So we also, let's say, give food to people and see how then their blood reacts to what they have eaten in a way. And there to sample the blood and to do this analysis, also medical doctors are needed, and that we cannot do ourselves. So so this is let's say the importance of the topic, because we eat 60 tons of food in our life and also 20 kilograms of pills. So 40,000 pills, I don't know, it should be a realistic number, I did not count. But Guy Vergère, he counted in literature the number of publications on food and on drugs. And then he made the following quotation, that there is 30,000 more publications on drugs than on food per gram ingested. So it means there's a lot of attention on drugs, but not so much on food. But despite that, food is very important for our health, we know that, and there's a lot of diseases that are associated with food. So this is the model system we develop in the NutriChip project. It's the, say, the biological principle is directly borrowed from the gastrointestinal tract. So you see here the kind of schematic where there is an epithelial cell layer. So the food, which is digested, passes here. And then the food elements, they pass through the epithelial cell layer. They come into the circulation systems where there are immune cells, white blood cells on the other side. So we mimic that in the NutriChip. So we have here a porous membrane on which you seed cells. They go into confluency, so they give you a closed epithelial cell layer. Then you can stimulate these with different types of food, also with LPS, which is lipopolysaccharide. It's kind of protein that's carried by toxic bacteria. So we can stimulate, in fact, your cells. And on the other side, there are immune cells, and they will respond in a way to what is offered here on this side. And then there is a kind of complex, let's say, cascade of reactions. So there will be a generation of cytokines, which are markers for inflammation. And we know as cytokines, there are interleukins, and there's also tumor necrosis factor alpha. I mention them here because they will come back later. Now here we see how we can do something in favor of creating inflammation, creating cytokines. And now the goal of this project is to see if we have milk or milk-derived products, how can they decrease these? In fact, how can they be in favor of a lower inflammation? So this is just to show that the reality is much more complex, because here was a nice scheme, very simple, straight on, but here you see, for example, the tumor necrosis factor alpha. In this reaction, there's another reaction with all different types of cells. So the reality is much more complex than this simple scheme. So we have only a very crude approximation of the living system. So here you see how we then, let's say, make these different parts of the system. So there is a compartment with the epithelial cell layer. These are Kakko2 cells. There are monocytes which are in a second compartment, and you can monitor inflammation on the monocytes themselves by looking at certain biomarkers. But you can also look at this liquid here, so they secrete some molecules, cytokines, which are then transported to a next compartment, and there you can detect them specifically with the magnetic bead-based assay. So there are different ways for looking at inflammation biomarkers. So here is then the schematic of the microfluidic chip, where you see the first compartment, which has a porous membrane, second compartment, and then the last compartment. And in between, there are valves that can be operated, so you have pressure from the exterior, and then you can open the valve, because for example, this one, there are cells that need to be 20 days in culture. Here is much less, so during the 20 days, you leave the valve closed, and then you flow through the liquid to the next one. So it needs to be operated in a good sequence. So the NutriChip project has the following parts. There is transwell-based gastrointestinal tract, and a transwell is a commercial device. You can buy that. It's about 1 centimeter square, so you can culture cells, and then also there's a lower compartment where you can culture the white blood cells. Then we have the micro gastrointestinal tract, which is the NutriChip, which is the consumable, if you want, of the NutriChip project. There is the CMOS imager, because we want to detect, finally, the biomarkers by looking at the fluorescence, which is a measure for the concentration of the cytokine of interest. So we develop here a very sensitive CMOS-based camera, and also there are algorithms for trying to be as sensitive as possible with the detection system. And then there is the human study, where we say compare the chip-based results with the say the human development of cytokines as a response to food intake. And then there is an add-on project which is on calcium bioavailability, so also a very essential element. So we want to study how calcium is transported through the epithelial cell layer and comes to the other side. So this is using the same platform as NutriChip, but for the nutrikinetic study. So actually, I will discuss these parts, which are now in progress. There is the chip hardware, there's also software of algorithm. Then there is the artificial gastrointestinal tract, where we work on artificial digestion, or I'll say, you cannot apply directly milk to the chip because it's digested milk, which is cut. All the proteins are cut in small parts by an artificial digestion process. And then we have the transwell system, and the micro gastrointestinal tract. And then there is the human study, where we give milk or meals, different type of meals to people, and then see how they react. So we had these people, and we were also on television, so it was a kind of a one-day film. So we had a few volunteers, and our PhD students and postdoc, they note, because they should really eat everything. And then they were eating, let's say, a lot, and at the end they were forced by the PhD student to continue until it was really finished. So it would be very good if you could have a NutriChip, and then people would not have to suffer for science like they have done that day. Maybe Nani, for next meeting we can prepare meals for the people of the NutriChip. So this brings me to the conclusion. So we have now a viable cell co-culture system in a transwell, so the macroscopic transwell system. We fabricate now a second version of the NutriChip. We have demonstrated, let's say, fluorescent imaging with the assembled camera. And there is the food digestion process that has been artificially, simulated, if you want. And there's also calcium availability studies that have started, and we have first results now from the human study. And finally, I want to thank you for your attention in name of all people of the NutriChip project. As I walked along the supposed golden path, I was confronted by mysterious specters.